Alright, I think I'm here. Yes, it's videoing. Okay, so it's been a while, I know. So anyway, I'm here and I'm like, well, with all this climate change excitement, where I've had these big groups, you know, marching in the streets, change it. And then I'm like, well, I don't know, let's do some doomsday scenarios. Okay, so today I was reading from the CO2 site that there is a big chance, a possibility of two of our major continents of this little cutesy planet drying out to the point where the wheat, because the wheat doesn't need to be irrigated, that the wheat goes and doesn't happen. Okay, so we have no wheat on one continent and then no wheat on another. Okay, so I'm like, okay, well, how terrible is that? And then I'm like, well, don't just people just switch to brown rice or tapioca starches and start mixing things and adding millet? Don't they do that? And then I'm like, well, it won't be that simple. So what will actually happen is it will be like a tenfold collapse of our food economy, okay? Just the wheat, because the wheat has been just like the bolster, the foundation. It's been the foundation for the chickens and for the cows and for the pigs. It's a foundational, okay? It's a foundation for the breadbasket eaters. They have to have their bread every day, their cereal every day. It's a foundation for them, okay? So the humans are gonna be like, well, they'll just switch, you know, they'll switch right away to something cheaper, or they'll think, I'll go to corn, but it won't be that way. Instead, that group, like there's a Mary's Gone Crackers or whatever, they'll switch to her style, and because she makes it gluten-free and there's no wheat or whatever, they'll go to those. But she and her little business can only make so many. You know, so there's maybe she makes 100,000 a year in boxes. She would be required to make 1,000,000, and she can't do that. She doesn't have that supplier. Okay, so that won't happen. So they'll be taken off the shelves right away. You know, people will run to the store and they will grab every Mary's Gone Crackers away. They'll take them and they'll hoard them, because we won't have any wheat. Okay, there won't be any other options. So all the other crackers will be taken. Okay, so now we've lost all the crackers off the store shelves, and the people are panicking. And it's like, what is going on? And then little by little, now you're going to start to see the beef prices rise. You're going to see the poultry start to rise, get higher and higher. What was the other one? The piglets, all of them get higher and higher, because that's what they eat. There will be no more wheat. Okay, so when all this is going on, what else happens? Then the prices are going to start to go up, because the people are going to switch to corn. They're going to switch to other things. And so the corn prices are going to raise through. They're going to raise through. The corn is going to maybe even go a double to what it is. So you know, when you had the shortages of the gasoline, it'll be very similar to the gasoline shortage when the gas went, and when people had to stand in line, you know, for the gas. Well, instead you can't get the wheat anymore. It'll be like that'll be for the corn, and that is going to be double the price. So we're going to be waiting for that corn, and it'll be double the price. So it's going to be kind of like, yikes. You know, for, well, where one major thing, you know, that we all depended on, is gonna drive up the prices of all of the other things. So now, what won't be expensive? You know, and I'm like, well, this is terrible, because most of the world eats corn tortillas, and if they can't, if their corn tortilla prices are rising high to a higher level because of the wheat collapse, then very bad for impoverished nations. So there's going to be a crippling economy there for the people, where corn tortillas are going up in price. So that's going to be terrible. Okay, so yeah, losing wheat is a bad thing, because it's such a dependent. Okay, so next, Is there any more excitement? Well, the people who are raising their own food and having their own gardens and are self-sustainable, they're fabulous. They're immune. They're going to be immune to the breakdown. The others, though, the store shoppers, are not immune. They're not immune in the least. They will be going, gone at the whim and the mercy of what price leveling and price readjustments are going to be made on those grains, because grains are going to start skyrocketing. Millet will be higher priced. All of those will skyrocket because wheat will not be available. Canola has already skyrocketed, but yeah, so we'll have the canolas and the millets and the corn, and the rice itself will also shoot through. So anyway, that's all. That was all. Big deal. So is it going to be a minor economic collapse or a big one? I think it's going to be a big economic collapse because we're talking about the mainstay and even the tortilla market being hurt and injured all the way around the world, where people can't even eat tortillas at a cheap price. Tortillas will probably double in price. Okay. That's all. That's all. That's all I have to say. I know. It was kind of a just a the next level of what's going to happen. I don't know where they got all this data about the wheat fields going foul all at once, but they will. Apparently, when one drought happens on one continent, it's a double drought on the other for the wheat. And when that happens, that's going to be just like those gas shortages. So we have to look at it that way. And people are going to hoard food. They're going to hoard food. And who will be immune? Well, fruitarians. Fruitarians, you're going to fare well. Not all vegetarians will, because the vegetarians who eat cheese, they are not going to fare well, because the dairy will be more expensive, because all of those things that were involved with the wheat, getting the wheat even near a cow, would be involved. And so dairy itself, they'll all be forced to be corn-fed, or oats. They'll try to find oats, but chances are the oats are going to be injured also. And even the corn, I don't know. I mean, oh my gosh, if we lose the corn, guess what? Less grains, and we're going to be going back to evolution, when we didn't even really eat that many grains. We were just like the birds. Just like the birds, and we just drifted around and had some fruit, and then we drifted back around and had some more fruit, and then we had maybe a little bit of this and a little bit of that, and that's the way it goes. So yeah, it's gonna be a tough thing. So when we're talking about this climate change, I'm a little bit weirded by it, because in a strange fix-it way. You know, if we get this global collapse of the wheat market, we're going to be like, well, everybody just go vegan, because guess what? Your chickens are costing too much now to eat, and your beef is costing too much to eat, and so is your cheese. So just go vegan, you know, because those prices are all going to run up. So in a way, it's good for vegans. We're gonna have our what? Our last ha-ha, everybody. You know, fruits and vegetables. Gosh, you know, it would be nice to include corn, wouldn't it? You know, let's not lose that. I don't know. It's about climate change, and you know what? They never ever drop the car prices for electric fast enough. I just don't see it happening. I don't see us happen having a, what's the word? I don't see us having a repair in time. So, because I don't see it as having a repair in time, we're not going to fix and mend all that industry yuck. We're not going to be able to stop all those cows and their methane, because none of that is going to happen in time. Anyway, I don't know. I've said a lot out here. I've said a lot out here. And a lot of you are still fighting and hoping and praying. And I'm just, and I guess I've become cynical, give up on it. I'm cynical, give up on the planet as a heal. I don't think it's going to heal. I don't think we're going to recover. I think the money madness machine was just too high for people. It's just too hyping, it's too high that they can't drop the money madness machine. Therefore, we lose. It's just gonna go like that. Anyway, wish I had a happy out for everybody. But well, I don't know. Yet again, go vegan. Oh, I don't know. One guy, I don't know, there was a report, no cancer. No cancer, everybody, if you're vegan. Woo-woo. Not even that's enough, is it? Not even that is enough to make people change. And then I met this new brain arrangement that maybe it's just mommy and daddy. Mommy and daddy are paying their bills, and mommy and daddy say, "You have to eat what we eat, darling. You have to eat what we eat." Thusly, guess what? They weaned out another one of them, a no changer, a pollutant, a non-stopper. That's it. I don't even know how to turn this machine off anymore. I found how to use my volume again, so watch out. It's been like weeks and weeks. I got a focuser machine, like a focusing rail. And after all of these like school shootings, it's really strange because it says shoot, like right on the label. I'm like, are you kidding me? The company's name is called Shoot. So I'm a little freaked out about it. I'm like, maybe I'll just paint over it with nail polish or something. Yeah, it's vulgar. It's vulgar. Anyway, yeah, I've been doing a little bit of camera work, and then something else. Oh, I'm making a wall, an interior garden wall. It's nice. It's nice. Anyway, I'll talk again another day about my cynical, it's not gonna get fixed. Dramatica. Oh, I sang yesterday though, and that was good because I was after like 2 months I didn't sing. But anyway, it's still there, and I remembered all of the words. Yes, even to echo, and I'm very happy. Yeah. Aha, Moreau. I remember the words, Moreau. Okay, Nutters. I guess Greta is our loudest voice, our most obnoxious voice at the moment, our most kindish voice in a way. But the older as we age, you know, we lose that. We don't have that gumption. We're just a bunch of snivellies that just internalize. And we don't get that power march going self. Less and less, you know, we lose it. So good for her, and let's hope it lasts as long as possible. Because I don't know, waking up these brains, sometimes you gotta whip them, you know, whip them verbally, and that's what she's doing. Okay, guys, I'm really gonna stop this. I see the square now. Ciao.